Ryau, live from the block, long time coming, man. It's pavement time, baby.
Live from the block, the pavement season 3. They said, Ron Murray, you gotta get the OG. So I got the original block, G-O-A-T. Battle rap, introduce yourself, man.
Ryau, man. If you know, then you know. You know what I mean? But
Ryau?
Yeah, baby. Yeah. It's been a long time fucking coming, man. I'm glad y'all, like I said, I thought my name was dead, bro.
Of course not.
Here he come. So it's gotta mean something. I appreciate it, though, for real.
Hey, it's the third season of The Pavement. It's only right that we get one of the original go to the block. Your name still rings bells. No matter how you feel about it, your name still rings bells. So let's get right to it. Ryau, born and raised in Fort Worth. Talk about how you got into battle rap.
Well, shit, to really answer that, I gotta go a little forward so I can go backwards, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? Because when I started battling, I didn't even know what the fuck it was, you know what I mean? I probably seen maybe 10, 15 battles to my name, and I was freestyling to these cats and at parties and whatever the fuck I make it do, and then somebody said, you ever heard of King of the Dot? You know what I mean? You ever heard of this or that? It's like, no, but I'm freestyling. I'm like, bro, you can compete. You should really push yourself out there and go do that. And so I looked it up, you know what I mean? I didn't have no real influences. I was just listening to hip-hop in general, but I seen a couple battles and was like, yo, these cats is fucking crazy. This is the best rapping I've ever heard in my life. And who are these people? You know what I mean? They don't got no name, got no, like nothing. So it was only correct for me to put my foot in the door and link up with. So this man right here is actually who told me, hey, there's a league down the road, man, but you ain't ready. He was like, you ain't ready for it. And I wasn't having it. And a month later, I'm battling and I'm winning. And he's like, bro, but kind of a weird story, real sketchy, but I jumped into it real fast.
Okay, so you talk about not having a lot of battle influences. So what type of music were you listening to? What were some of the artists that influenced your style?
I'm super boom bap rapper. Like, Nas, my favorite rapper. So obviously Ether and shit like that. I can go on and on, you know, the Wu-Tang shit. A little, you know, anything that's got bars involved with it that ain't the hibbity-bibbity shit you're hearing today.
No lyrical miracle, right?
Nah, yeah, you know what I mean? It's got to make sense. It's got to make, you know what I'm saying? But that's pretty much what it was, man. I had nothing, bro. Like, it's crazy the amount of battles I watched before I did my own. You know what I mean? I just felt like I could do this shit, push myself, and I fucking did it. Really, because he said I wasn't ready. Mm-hmm. It was really just not going to happen.
All right, so introduce everybody in the room. Introduce yourself too, because definitely we're gonna start. We're gonna start from the right, and we can go all the way around. Everybody, introduce yourself real quick. All right,
man. I'm Joey. I've been knowing this man for a long time. Told me he can be a rapper. He's making it.
All right. So I'm Wayne, A.K.A. Paniac. You know what I mean? Long Straw, Fort Worth, Texas. Representing. Sure enough.
B. Hall, the man behind the man.
Right. So, B-Hall, talk about it. You saw the battle rapping, you threw it out to Ryau, you threw the little bait, man, I don't think you're ready. How did that all work out with Ryau?
It was a mindset thing, you know what I mean, trying to get his mind right. But, you know, when I first seen him, I knew he had it. You know what I mean, the way that he carried himself, the way that he put his words together, you know what I mean, the way he's charismatic with, you know, how he put his words and everything. So I always knew that he had it in him. And he was young, too, and it was a growing, you know, development of battle rapping coming on. So I just wanted to see if he was ready, which I already knew.
Yeah, he knew about this shit. I had no idea. He'd already been to an event. Yeah. I think he'd
That's why I'm gonna ask there. Next. What was battle rap in the Metroplex at that time? If there was battle
there
rap,
wasn't.
At that
time. There wasn't. And, okay. And if it was, it was shit.
This was a couple years ago, mind you.
Right. 2015.
Right. Shit. Mm-hmm. I was 19, 20 years old when he told me that shit. And then 21, I'm battling. But at the time, that bro, it wasn't shit. And if it was, it was just a bar with people drinking and shit. It wasn't no, and I think Pac Manson said it the best, man. It was just a fucking bar.
Pac Manson, shout out to the man.
Shout out to Pac Manson, man.
Why so serious?
But nah, man, it was nothing. It was, and they were trying to make it happen. They were trying to do it, you know, trying to make it, but you hear the bar noise in the background.
Right.
100 people here, only 30 of them watching the battle. Everybody else is gonna talk and have a good time. You can't blame them. But you had to start somewhere, you know what I mean? And that's where building this shit up started.
So when did you meet Oso?
I met Oso, I was actually a judge for Pac Manson and the Red battle.
Shout out Pac Manson and Red.
Shout out Pac Manson, shout out Red.
That fucks with Red, dude.
Yeah, Red, nice. He wanted me, because I got information from him. Hit up Oso, like, hey, I want a battle. He's like, how do I know you nice? I'm like, well, shit. And I sent him some bullshit, the booth.
Yeah.
Fucking, I sent him some bullshit, and he couldn't really hear it, but it was bar heavy, you know what I mean? I'm rapping my ass off. And he's like, I tell you what, I want you to be a judge for me. So he told me to come out to an event, gave me the address, blase blah. And the rest was kind of history. I met him on stage that night. We talked it up a little bit. And then he lined me up on my first shit. And he trusted me.
First battle.
Talk about that first battle against Young Mel. The preparation going into it was what you expected.
Who in the
head? Man, that was crazy as far as timing and shit goes too, because I am the first boot camper ever.
First, so there was a boot camp when you started.
It was not called boot camp.
Okay, go ahead.
I made that. That was me. I did that. I didn't name it. Oso did, but he was like, you know, battle before the lead. Like, yeah. You have to do this, and we talked about it actually, and yeah, man, it was the very first boot camper. It was in a shit with 2104. It was fucking no bigger than this. It was little bitty, man. It was little bitty. And hot as hell, man.
But it was
hot as shit.
It was
hot as shit. I had no hat. I took my hat off and everything. It was hot as fuck, man. But yeah, man, Young Mel was Young Mel. I don't think he was ready for what the fuck was going to hit him. Like,
yeah, he didn't take it serious. He thought he was just going to come in there and push.
I think he was going to freestyle all the time.
Like push over and shit. Like, he didn't know what he was
doing. He seemed like he was more of a musician. That's why I got a little bit from him.
But I don't know that motherfucker. I ain't heard a song from him. I don't know nothing about you, dog. He had pictures with Rick Ross and shit. He was flashing. He was like posting shit like, how can I lose? I'm so dope. How can I
lose?
And you know me on social media, it ain't there, dog. I ain't barking back at nobody. Just you come see the fight, come see the fight.
And then I think there, me and all of everybody that was there that was supporting Ryu, I think we all got in Young Mel's head because we was turned up that night.
We're going to get to that.
It was his first battle and shit. Like, we was there, and I think we just got to him, you know what I mean?
We're going to talk about that atmosphere. So, with the Young Mel battle, when you went into it, was it written? Was it freestyle? How did you go into that?
Everything I ever do, I have three written rounds.
So you wrote, because to me it looked like it could have been effortless, but it seemed like you freestyled, but it was written though.
I always been a firm believer of, if you can write, you're gonna come up with three rounds, because I'm not gonna waste nobody's time. So regardless of what's gonna happen, you're gonna get three out of me. I don't give a fuck if there's a freestyle in it or not. But if you can throw them freestyles in there, and everybody knows that was a freestyle, because they know it, you can tell, you can look at a motherfucker and be like, he wrote that down or he freestyled that.
Right.
And then still finish, that's just an extra little on top, you know what I'm saying? That's wow, whoa, buddy up here cooking for real. Yeah. I've always been a firm believer that was an extra tool in my pocket that I always had, like.
And I think you can really see, my bad, not to cut in the mic, I think you can really see like the reaction of the crowd that Young Mel, that first battle, that was his first impression. Everybody, I knew he can spit. Like, he knew he can spit.
Everybody did.
Everybody there that came to support Ryu knew he can spit, but it was just like, he was giving us that first impression, like, he up here spitting and shit, and you can really see in the crowd, like, how the crowd reaction, if you go back and watch that battle, like I do many times, to go back and watch the first Young Mel battle, you can see how the crowd, you know what I mean, was like, damn.
So let's talk about that crowd. How was that atmosphere at Froggy's? How, because I hear it, battle rap then wasn't battle rap now, where you might see more white teeth, handshakes and everything. I heard it was a lot different back then, especially in Froggy's.
Shit was not friendly at all. Shit was not friendly. Thank God nothing really, really happened, you know what I'm saying?
But, yeah.
I mean, I had homies fucking dropping the gun by the fence and going back there and picking it up when they get in and shit. Like, I had, like,
we don't gotta implicate nobody.
Nah, I ain't saying no name. I ain't saying no name. Nah, but it was just that tight. You know what I mean? Like, that shit made diamonds out of people, that pressure, you know what I'm saying? Like, you really had to really fucking focus and lock it in. Don't be stupid. We're gonna have some drinks, but nobody getting drunk and froggies like that. And we used to call it froggy face. People used to go in there and get fucking hammered. Mm-hmm. But that was before there was hostility and two grown men yelling at each other, calling each other bitch in front of everybody. I got my homies out here. I'll be damned if you call me a bitch, I'll break your fucking neck. That's how people would think. Yeah. That's how people would think, you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. But nah, it was cool, but the battling definitely made that shit tight. It ain't what it is today. It is not. Back then, like I said, you might have a little click over here, a little click over here, a little click over here with them two on it. They ain't meshing. You know what I'm saying? They don't like each other. So that's something outside of the battle rap. You worry about a fight breaking out of the corner. You know what I mean? It was not fucking it. You know what I'm saying? And that bar shit pissed me off. That whole, like, I don't know. It wasn't it. It was hostile. That's pretty much how I'm going to put it plain.
So those early days of the block, what were just some of the trials and tribulations? Because you're definitely one of the foundations, one of the early tiers. Really, there is no lie from the block without Ryau. I've heard nothing but great things about you. People say you are the GOAT of really probably DFW battle rap. So how were those early days just really promoting live from the block and really battle rap to an area that didn't have it?
For me, these guys right here, it's nothing with, you know, if your team ain't strong, you know what I mean? And I wish I could have 30 other motherfuckers sitting right here that put their hand in this shit.
There's a lot of us.
And
I can tell in the crowd. Yeah, I can tell in the crowd.
But that's not because they're my fans, that's my family, that's my friends. I like to think I'm a likable guy, you know what I'm saying? I go around, keep my, you know, my shit straight, you know what I mean? I shoot it to you straight. If I tell you I'm gonna do something, I'll do something. And man, it's kinda hard to say because there's so many different, I don't know how to put this shit. I don't know, man. Repeat the question.
Oh, nah. So pretty much just talk about, you know, the early struggle. Because, of course, you're running the rising stars on battle rap in an area that doesn't have battle rap. Or you may see the URL and King of the Dot was around at that time. So how was it going about saying, I battle rap? Because you definitely had support. A lot of guys don't. A lot of guys do not have, they can't bring a dead man to the battle. You get what I'm saying? But you always had that support. So how was it for you to go out and say, hey, come out to these battles, come out to Live from the Block? How was that?
Again, like I said, my fault, I got sidetracked. It's these guys. That's kind of like my networkers, you know what I'm saying? And for me, I appreciate you calling me, saying nice things about me. They like my networkers, man. They like, you know, I don't want to say like army ants or anything like that, but they was the ones I was always like, yo, I got a place I can go, we can turn up, we can do this. And I know a guy can rap. You want to rap, you know what I'm saying? Boom, 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 blah, blah, blah. But putting my hands on that foundation and laying brick for brick like that, man, was fucking, that was heartwarming to me to know that, because people like Oso would tell me that all the time. People like, you know, other people in the crowd like that all the time. And we ain't have it, like you said, man. It wasn't a battle rap scene. This shit was not a thing yet.
And this is pre-YouTube. Like, this is kind of
people. Right, where this shit was just now getting to pop off. And again, Pac said it perfect too. He had a little group of people that was battling then. You know what I mean? He had a little group of people that was battling then. And it was just them. And battling each other, it wasn't nothing. And then I came in and fucking made this shit serious. I feel like I put a serious note on it. Like, okay, now it's time for y'all to shake the fuck up. This ain't your homeboy you rattling no more. Mm-hmm. I'm here to take everybody's fucking head off. And again, I hate to sound cocky like that. I call it cocky humble. Cause I don't bash you on the internet. I don't bash you doing that shit.
You don't do the social media.
I don't do that social media shit. I ain't doing that. I'm cool with you, man. I ain't got nothing against you, you know what I'm saying? Unless I'm really pissed. But coming up like that, man, I felt like my chest high, undoubtedly, confidently being like, I'm a beast. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to do this and I'm going to prove it. And I did everything to do that. But with that serious tone coming in, the whole shit shifted. That's when people were like, okay. And then even Oso started getting real sharp with his editing and getting better and better. We all just got better and better and better. And ultimately where it's at today, you know what I mean?
The name Ryau, how did that come about?
Freestyling with the homies.
Okay.
My name, I did not name myself. My name was not Ryau. I just kind of put a play on words because my name's Ryan, flip the lowercase N, you got the U.
Let's go.
You know what I mean? And my homie was rapping at Big N, San Bernardino N. And he was like, he said something, I beat him up like Street Fighter Ryu or something like, and he kept pointing at me. And I was like, yeah, that kind of just stuck. And then when I was coming to battle, that's perfect. Street Fighter, 3 rounds. You got what I'm saying? So you got 1, 2, 3. So Ryau was perfect. And then, shout out to Mike P. Why you want to be like me, bro?
hey, that's why we have this right here.
He stole my whole shit.
So after the Young Mel battle, the Skits battle was next up, correct? So did you feel more comfortable going into the skits battle?
I felt the same amount of confidence through every one of my battles. I've never not one time been shaken, never not one time been shook for no opponent, especially when it comes to battle rap. None ever. Different. I guess it was kind of the same as far as how I approached it, the writing and stuff like that. But the skits one had definitely a little bit more freestyling involved with that one. Mm-hmm. And another confidence boost for me as far as I can do it. I can really free with the battles and shit. But shout out to skits though, man. Like I said, we text a while back, man, and like I said, I was like, we've been to war together, and he was like, yeah, we have. And I fuck with Five, I fuck with all y'all, man.
Shout out Five.
Absolutely.
So with that, would you say at that point after the skits battle, that's when, did you realize that you were the face of the block, or you was just, you know, going to work doing your thing?
Nah, I was kind of doing my thing, and then after the skits one, when the hype started coming and they started making memes and all kind of.
Okay, let's get to that. Hey, let's get to the bar breakdown. Sorry to cut you off. Let's get to the bar breakdown.
I gotta hear this.
Y'all made me public enemy number one, and it's already listed. But I still try to figure out how I actually did this. Oh, I know why. Because I came in the door with a good vibe and good business. Because I can rap, and for that solo fact, the rest of you got offended. I'm something that can help this scene grow to a higher percentage. Linking up with Oso to reach over 300 subscriptions. And it's guys like you with all that babbling and bitching that keeps me and other MCs from taking this league beyond its limits. Let's talk about the hate you got, Ryan. Let's talk about it. You were the one at that point in time. You talked like you were the one. Talk about that. Matt, you had battle,
300 subscriptions. Listen to what you just said.
Yeah.
What it got now, damn it, 40,000?
Crazy.
Let you know how shit goes back in time.
Let's go.
I'm 30 fucking years old, man. I was battling young. But that right there, yeah, I was strutting my shit. And I was telling him how I actually write rhymes. Like, I'll put them on my phone. But then if I find something I really like, a couple weeks before the battle, I had to write it on paper. And then I incorporated something. And I thought of that like 2 weeks before that fucking battle. Because he was going crazy with the, and God rest his soul, Matt Chad.
R.I.P. Matt Chad.
Rest in peace, man. But I did not like the cat at the time. I was really had something against him. All that. They don't realize they poking a bear when they do all that shit.
Especially somebody, with the social media just in.
Exactly. I don't realize you're poking a bear. I never said a word to them. I never said nothing to them. And here they are with all these pictures and all this goofy ass shit. And that's fucking hilarious. That's, I had like four of mine that you may have done. And yeah. That was one of them. That's crazy. Yeah, man, I was strutting my shit at that point. I really felt like fuck y'all, like everything, me against the world, you know what I mean? I mean, I had my homies, but I had no team, I had no dojo, I had no lojo, I had no gojo, bojo bands, none. I had none of that shit. None of that shit. It was
you
me.
You weren't clicking
up
or
me.
So you wrote your own stuff. You know,
every
riding teams
single
or nothing
but no,
like that.
This man was my punching bag. He sat right okay. there and watched me.
He said that, yeah.
I feel like I offended him more than I did half these rappers. But he was somebody I could look at and spar with, you know what I mean? Just to get my shit up, how I should be aggressive or what I should do and no pointers. Oh, you should do it. You should move your hand like that. Nah. You should karate chop. Nah, none of that shit. It was just me just getting my shit up, talking with my chest out, doing what I know I could do, pretty much. You know?
So and this is just a little bit off the scene what we're talking about. Like you said, it's you in the garage growing a beard, two beards, just getting after it,
exactly.
You on the ad.
Exactly, and I'm on it. And I'm on that ass, man. Y'all over here making Ryu dick pics and stuff. You should have been focused on writing. You should have been focused on getting your shit correct, because that's how, at that point I was super dangerous. I could have done anything at that point. And I was really, and we'll get to it later, I was supposed to ship off and battle Tone Montana and do all kinds of shit.
We're going
to
get them, most definitely. So did you start noticing, you know, because of course the Mad Chad battle, did you start noticing other people in the block acting kind of funny towards you? Because at the end of the day, I totally believe you can't stop what's for you. So of course you're ascending to the top, the face of the league. Did you even see like, you know, more people coming like, man, I could take this guy or whatever. Did you feel the target on your back?
Yes and no, because people act completely different in your face. Completely different. And then they go home and then all of a sudden it's blah, blah, blah. Old boy said this, old boy said that shit. Like, that shit is for the fucking birds. I did not do that. I did not act like that. If I see you, I see you. If I offend you, I offend you. If I got a target on my back, I got a target on my back. Come get me. And here's the thing. I never, like, people use this term ducking, right? They use this term ducking, right? No, you at this point, again, cocky, humble, and I ain't, no, you gonna have to, yeah, I got bigger fish to fry, dog. I started right here, I want that. And then after I do that, I want to be at. And that's exactly what it was. I wasn't ducking you. I got time to prepare for this one man. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going to beat Danny Myers in battle every week. Like, that's not going to happen. I want to put my best out there and 100% into it.
So that's what I was going to get to you next. So with the battles, like, about how much time would you say was in between the male battle, the skits battling, like, just the, because now, to your point, people battle almost every
it's
other week,
crazy.
If not the same week.
No.
But I feel that when you do that, there's going to be, your bars are going to get saturated. So how was just your writing process along with that, you know, with, because I don't think it's bad when people take less battles, because I believe you do get better content in a lot of ways.
You do. I mean, look at, like, Nitty right now in the league. I know he just got beat by Swamp in the tournament, but when he's sitting and stewing.
I was surprised to hear that. Yeah,
He's sitting and stewing, when it's like, I ain't heard from Nitty in 3 months. He ain't posting nothing on Facebook. He ain't done nothing. That's dangerous, man. Yeah. Back up. That boy finna hurt something. But they were all different time lengths, though. Some of them were like,
maybe like a week.
3 months, and then it would be like 2 weeks, and then, because I took the mail battle on 2 week notice.
Okay.
I didn't have a bar wrote down. I didn't have one line wrote down. 3 rounds in 2 weeks.
And you don't have as much info on a person back then as now. So
exactly.
You're literally battling, you writing the right.
Right. If I'd have known he was 4 foot tall, I'd have been like, young male, you get it? Like, yeah. Man, yeah. But no, I had no idea, man. But they were all different time lengths. It was never like a set in stone, like, oh, it's going to happen. Because I know me and Chad got rushed. Because the next event, Disaster, came down. And that was when I was supposed to battle Chad then. And Oso was like, man, I kicked myself in the ass for that one.
So that's what I want to get to. So was Mad Chad the first, you versus Mad Chad, the first real blockbuster, you know, battle? Or would you say you versus King? Because it seemed like the Mad Chad battle, it was intense. It seemed like it could go somewhere else. Your guys were there. Was that like, the room was rocking. Would you say like that was the first like premier battle that the block had?
It was the biggest as far as numbers.
Yeah,
there was so many people there. Like, I had my uncles and shit there. I had like my like blood, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. All them was there with all them cousins and uncles. Like, it was huge. I didn't battle Matt Chan like 1 o'clock in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
You remember that shit? Because they were all performing, dude. That was a crazy, that night was crazy.
So there were performances as well. Because y'all were still working to not just battle rap.
That's something I want to get into, how it really started, you know, as far as like the block. It, then it was like a series. It was a, you know, a concerts were going on.
It.
And it was, you know what I'm saying? And blase blah. It was more than just battle focus like it is now. Last one I went to, we whoop, get these battles out. We done. We out here 8:30, 9 o'clock. Like, whoa, this is not what I'm used to. I'm used to like, where the turn up at? Oh, so he's like, no, we gone. We out. It's like, damn, son, nice to see you, bro. I'm out. Like, you know what I mean? But now, like, as far as, like I said, like, them time limits go, man, they were few and far between as far as the number. Like, hey, you have 2.5 months. Next battle, you have 2.5 months. No, it wasn't like that. It was take it as it comes. This event's coming up on this day. You want to take it? What was that giving me? A month and a half? Fuck, it was rock. You know what I mean? Like, and that's how we all work. That's how everybody was like that. It wasn't, you know, we didn't talk to each other like, hey, bro, you want to battle? Bro, you want to battle? Like, it wasn't.
I was going to get to that. How did Oso just say y'all were just going to battle? Because I do want to get to that point as well.
No,
how were battles set up then?
But there wasn't really a structure at the time. It wasn't really like, it wasn't set in stone. And this is from what I can see. Like I said, me and Oso go past battle rap. That's my boy for
that's
real.
What's up.
That's
shout
my
out
boy
Oso.
For real. Shout out. Okay, only way I'm coming back is if Oso went back. That's it. No, that's my boy. That's my ace. I'm gonna 30 that man. No, man. It like I said. Oh, and first off, I'm gonna get that man his motherfucking flowers, man. I've seen that boy go through some motherfucking shit. I've seen him get his name get ran through the mud for no reason. I've seen that boy go through some shit, be down and out, about to quit 4, 5, 6, 7 different 8 times, and never did. Had the fucking ambition and hustle to fucking keep rolling. So that's my bit for you, bro, for real. I see you go through some shit, dog.
So I want to get to that point, you know, big shout out to Oso, because like I said, the block, I believe, is one of these situations where we can give people their flowers. Oso, you got to quit ducking. You're going to get a pavement interview, too, sooner or later. So when would you say, like, what battle or what moment in time would you say, like, we're here. There is battle rap in the Metroplex.
The King one.
Okay, so let's get to that, the King Battle. So the King Battle, and I heard it was supposed to be on A-Hat, just from, you know, what was supposed to be talked about.
Yeah, okay, it was supposed to be. That's his words. He wanted it over there. King wanted it over there. And that's something that we spoke about, you know. That battle actually got pushed an extra month, which I'm glad it did, because, boy, I was stewing at the time. I just was getting better and better and better and better and better. And he wanted it. That's what he said. And I even set a bar about it in the fucking, in the shit. But that was when it was really like, okay, things are going correctly. Things are flowing nicely. The card set up perfectly. Next rapper, battle up to my left, battle up to my right, boom, and it moved and flowed. It finally was making sense. And to top it off, that was the best fucking battle in Fort Worth to date. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't want to say anymore, but at the time, that shit was heavy, and it was going to take a long time for
so it was a big deal. You versus King was probably bigger than you versus Mad Chad.
No, yeah.
Oh, way. Okay, so the event before the King battle, Molly G's battle.
Shout out Molly G's.
I can't remember who he battled, but he did the whole his dad.
His dad versus Embassy. Yeah.
It was no. It was before then.
Okay. My bad. Okay.
Way before.
Okay,
then.
I didn't know that. Okay.
He showed up in a prisoner jumpsuit and stripped down. Pac-Man. He did. You know how he gets.
It was him and Pac Man.
No, it was. Just that dude that kept reading off his phone. He broke his phone. He said, "Bro, I lost my phone." He kept reading. Anyway, he cooked this dude, right?
Yeah.
And after that battle, it was like a little weird face-off with me and King. Like, we walked the middle of the stage, and Oso was behind us, and we just kind of looked at each other. And then, I don't know if Oso said, I don't know who said, but he was like, "You want to see Ryau versus King?" And that bitch went crazy. And I was like, bet. We hit that, walked away, and we got to work. You know what I mean? That's what we do is, you know, battle rapper. But the King one was definitely that we are here. Live from the Bar Wars. That was the real shit. And again, all of our hands had already been on the bricks. We were already building this house. And it was like, damn, the roof almost finished. Like, we really here. Like, we really, you know what I'm saying? I can cook in the kitchen now. You know what I'm saying? That was a good feeling to be a part of. And I had a lot of fucking fun that night. Mm-hmm. I had, like, over the moon fun that night. I still left early, so it was pissing me.
Hey, so with that, did you start seeing, you know, different fans start coming in the buildings? Did you start seeing different battlers who may have been the original guys? Did you start noticing that when the block started growing?
Yeah, that was because right about that time was when the boot camp was really taking off.
So the boot camp was really a name. There was a name for boot camp at
right,
the time.
Right, okay. It that's when it started becoming something. Like, I remember I slid off to the side. I don't even know if anybody's ever told you this. I slid off to the side. It was me, King, Pac Manson, Oso, and fucking, I'm pretty sure it was Fellow, battled on the back porch with just us
Shout
watching
out Fellow.
Them.
Yeah.
With just us watching them. There was no other crowd. And it was like, if you can cook right now, cook. you could cook later on type of shit. And that's what happened. It was grimier. It was so much grimier back then. But boot camp was popping off. The King shit popped off. Boom, the event was wonderful. It was all gravy and shit, man. And we were finally fucking, we had made the shit. Like, and it is what it is today. You know what I mean?
Okay, so, like I said, just going off here in the battle, you versus King possibly on Ahab, what were other opportunities that came to you? Because, of course, if you're the first person making noise like that, I'm for sure there are other opportunities that came through with you. So were there other opportunities from other leagues that wanted to, you know, get the Ryau experience?
DFW did on one occasion, but my fault of not networking and social media and shit like that hurt that opportunity. So I was like, my ear was never open, you know what I'm saying? And to answer the other question, as far as like when other people and fans was coming in and people like that, you started seeing new faces. You started seeing people that were like buying a ticket to literally enjoy a show. Mm. And they would continuously pop back up. Had nothing to do with rap, had nothing to do with nothing like that. And that was just another notch.
Yeah,
like,
just
fuck.
Place to be on that night, you know what I mean?
Right. We made this shit. We finally fucking here.
Be there or be square.
Yeah. And I think really with the situation, like, I think, like, you know, and we've talked about it off camera, like, battle rap, there are things that come with it, but I think at the same time, you can meet a lot of great people through battle rap.
You can.
Especially with the battle rap community.
Right.
And so, with it starting in Fort Worth, because the majority of the early battles we're at, Froggies, were in Fort Worth during this time, right?
Man. I know where you're going with this, but yes, everything was in the funk where it started.
Okay. So DFW battle rap started in the funk.
Yes.
Okay.
Live from the block, dude. I'll tell you that right now.
Yeah.
And then now it's like fucking everywhere.
But that's a good thing, though. No,
it's a great thing. It's a great thing, but with that brings different crowds and brings different energies and different environments and different people and different, you know what I mean? And, but you have to do that. You have to expand. URL goes from Houston to New Orleans to Atlanta to whatever the fuck they're going. You have to do that to be where you're going like that. But it was just foreign to me. You know what I mean? It was like, well, weirdos around. You know what I mean? It wasn't.
No.
But we can't be stuck in a box at the same time. So all right. You got to expand.
So Ryau doesn't do social media at the time. You are not cool with the social media. We talked about it a little bit, the social media games and what you didn't like about it. Because now it seems like it's part of it. But you can't be someone talking about someone's kids, talking about someone's mom. You're dead, it's relative. Then after the battle, everything's cool. That doesn't work everywhere, but I salute you in being not a social media guy from that aspect.
Nah, man, I thought that was the goofiest shit in the world. If you making memes about people, you bashing people, you doing it, that's fucking goofy, dog. And now people will say, but I'm selling a fight. Okay, good. Well, if you're good enough, you don't got to. So now it seems like some kind of insecurity. Now it seems like, oh, I need this band. Like, oh, I'm going to bash him over here. I'm going to bash him to the left, bash him to the right. But again, that's what it's become now. It's just a part of it. That's instilled in the game, but it wasn't always. You know what I mean? And that's what they want to do. Well, he going to say this to me. I'm going to say it back. Like, man, if y'all would have put all that time and energy that y'all doing on this bashing online on top of the writing you already doing, you imagine how good that battle would have been? Y'all fucking around doing some weird shit.
So, one thing I give you credit for is that you always keep the same demeanor and you're always cool on stage. So, which battle was more intense? The King battle or the Mad Chad battle? Because your guys were deep. That's probably, your battles were probably the only ones I've seen where Oso had to tell the crowd to really chill out from the events I went to. So, what were probably the more intense Ryau battles?
The Chad battle intense for a different reason. King battle intense for a different reason. Because the Chad one was more like that. Like the hostility was high, you know what I'm saying? The testosterone was flowing, you feel? Like everybody was like trying to get down, like it just seemed that way. The King one was different because of the level of rapping that was about to happen.
Okay, it was a high level rapper, shout out to King.
Yeah. Shout out, and it was just a different, you know, it was about to, and again, at that point, it's more professional. The Chad shit, I mean, from Chad to King, the level of professional, like it jumped, like it exponentially almost in my mind, like it really, we were figuring it out. Oso was figuring it out. And he put his
nose. His brand was building and it was already up. By the time the Chad and Ryau battle happened, Live from the Block was popping. Even though it was popping before, but it was building and then they got there.
It was ascending,
And then when he got to the King, it was like, okay, it's already, like you said, it's a different level of rapping and shit. Like
different,
everybody
different
knew like it was finna be hot that night. Like
I remember looking out in that fucking crowd, because the crowds was decent. I had my peoples with me, you know what I'm saying? So I was bringing 30 motherfuckers, 40 motherfuckers at a time.
You were getting your tickets off.
Right, my tickets was off, but they selling themselves. They were selling their fucking selves.
Everybody
man.
Can't do it.
I would just say, hey, I'm battling. I'm battling. And they'd be like, bet, drop the Addy, you know what I'm saying? So they would pull up. But I remember looking out at that King crowd and being like, my peoples are just right here. Whoa, like there was a lot of fucking people there. Like it was, the whole parking lot was filled up. And I couldn't see shit because the lights was in my, you know what I mean, on the stage. I couldn't see a fucking thing. But then when them shits turned off and I got off the stage, I was like, yo, get me out of this bitch. I'm getting claustrophobic, dog. It was too much. We all couldn't fit inside. That was at Chrome. We had to be outside. There was no way we could have been inside.
So how did that feel?
Fucking amazing. That was the best environment, like, I love the outdoor. For whatever reason, the outdoor was super, super dope to me. I liked it much more than being inside. Always will. Shit was dope.
Talk about the J Red battle. This has to be, if there's a battle rap version of Hangover, it has to be you versus J Red. Because you said that battle literally happened spontaneously.
3 seconds of decision making went on. Like there was no, like, we needed an adult in that bitch. Like we didn't know what we were doing. That was actually my bachelor party, bro. We weren't even supposed to be in the building. We weren't even supposed to be there. We was hopping from bar to bar to bar.
Let's go battle rap.
We go battle. Let's just go to the battles. Let's go. And old boy who was there, we were watching. I'm telling you, I'm so drunk, I have no idea who battled that night. I don't know who was on before me. I don't know what the fuck was going on. I don't know nothing about it. We show up, it's late, like the last battle's going on. We there, I got my boys with me and shit. And some dude from Boston, I can't remember his name, had a little homeboy with him. And I see him like whispering over to Oso, and Oso stands on the stage and he's like, hey, my boy from Boston got one round for somebody. And then I want to tell you, my brother kicked me in the back so motherfucking hard. I almost dropped everything, dog. I was like, God damn, I turned around and I was like, fuck it, let's go. And I get to the stage and Oso was like, dog, no way, you're not doing this. And I was like, I got it. He's like, dog, you're not doing
this. So you the GOAT. So pretty much at this point, are you saying you the GOAT of the block? Because that's what it seemed like.
At that point, yeah, okay. I felt that then.
And I salute you because a lot of people, when they did a spontaneous battle,
right.
When they did that and everything, and it's your bachelor party, you got to be somewhere the next day. Like you said,
I went to Mexico. I got married and went to Mexico in like 48 hours, bro. Cooked the man, got married, went to Mexico. This shit was crazy. But we, like, this shit was wild, bro.
Yeah.
And I got up there and Oso was like, he's looking, I was just laughing at me at this point. He's like, bro, you get cooked. I swear to God. Like, he's like, bro, you finna ruin it all right now in one night. And I was like, bro, I'm finna watch. I'm finna shake this bitch. And I shook that bitch.
Nah, he did, because Jay Red, like, he doesn't get enough credit as well. He's definitely, you know,
right.
The legends in Texas. So it could have went bad. And even when I was watching the video, I was like, man, Ryau don't got a lot of time to go second, but you did definitely did shake the room.
Five flips. That's all it took. As soon as I That big tuck shit had motherfuckers going nuts.
Oh, most definitely. And you from the funk shooting, saluting the Dallas guy? Oh, most definitely. People are always going to love that.
Absolutely.
You know, BFW. So after that, you took a break from battle rap. And I don't knock anybody for doing that because I believe battle rap, it definitely can burn you out. So during that time, before you did return versus Trabo, were you still keeping up with the block and seeing how it grew and everything?
Not really, man. I was actually supposed to fly out. OSAMA had me linked up to Battletoe, Montana.
It was
in New York, but my son was born the next day.
And I
turned it down and I said, no, I had my kid. And once I had my kid, bro, my life, it wasn't about me no more. It wasn't about going to bars. It wasn't about networking. It wasn't about talking to nobody. You know what I'm saying? Growing up with no pops, I was like, shit, I'm going to be, you know, daddy number one. You know what I mean? Like, I'm going to be father.
Happy Father's Day as well. Happy Father's Day to all y'all.
Thank you, brother.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's what happened. And then once I realized all my energy couldn't go, if I can't do it 100%, I ain't going to do it. If my heart's not all the way into it, I'm not going to do it. And it just never was. And like I said, once I had my kid, man, my whole life, my vision and shit just changed. And people was telling me, like, I remember, I think it was Skits. He was like, shout out to Skits. He was like, you get used to it. You get used to it. You know, you do the pops thing, you get used to it. And I just never got used to it. It was always something, you know what I mean? I'd rather play basketball, you know what I mean? I'd rather do other shit with my kids, you know what I mean? Focus my energy on them as much as I possibly can, you know what I'm saying? Outside of work and whatever the fuck it is, life and shit. But the Trabo shit was my nod. So let's try this one more time, because Oso would
Let's put a pin on that, because I definitely want to talk about Artist Connect too. Go ahead and talk about that, because I do want to get to the Trabo and how he got on your radar, but salute to Artist Connect. Talk about that a little bit.
Artist Control.
My bad. I apologize.
That's a family member of mine. He actually put me on at the Young Male Battle from out the gate. He's like, man, if you're battling, you know what I mean, I might hook you up with some clothes, you know what I mean, I might lace you up and shit. I got off the stage at Young Up Alabama. First thing he said was, what size you wearing? First thing he said, he didn't say shit. And he came over to my house and gave me a ball closet. Remember Artist Control shit, Master Jordans, whatever the fuck. But that's my boy. Shout out to Crook, you know who I'm talking to. And that's my guy, man. He's been supporting me. He's in Dominican Republic right now. He would be right here. I hit him up to come, but he's like, man, I can't. I'm sliding in the morning, getting on a plane. But again, just like these guys around me, networker, putting me on, putting my name out there, you know, with a good tag on it, you know what I'm saying? Like, dude, solid. If he says it, he's gonna do it, you know what I mean? So shout out to fucking Crook, man. That's my guy.
And also, we talked about more battle rap connections and everything, to how that goes about in the Metroplex and how you're connected, correct?
Yeah, shit. That's talk your shit.
Yes,
please. Talk your shit. Yes.
I mean, just as far as, you know, I mean, seeing the people who have the talent to go out there and get the people what they need, as far as the battling, I mean, I meet a lot of people, see a lot of people, you know what I mean, online, Twitter, you know what I mean,
personally.
Yeah, personally. I mean, I met someone else, you know what I mean, on Twitter, who I per se introduced to a scene. She's doing her thing.
Shout out KCJ.
She
was on
killing it.
She was in the building at the Mad Chat battle.
Yeah.
She was there, Artist Controlled up with me. She actually had a battle for the DFW League. Mm. We went there, it was laced up. Did her thing, she cooked old girl. Then we left, went to Live on the Block.
Hold on, so this is the same night?
Yeah, same.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yeah. It used to be like that, man. I'm telling you, shit was rocking way different back then. Way different.
So was there a competitive level with Live from the Block and DFW when they decided to come? Or is it, because to me, when I met the DFW guys, they knew about Live from the Block, but it didn't seem like they necessarily wanted to get ingratiated, even though, sometimes two things can exist, but they'll act like neither one is there. Mm-hmm. So was it really like that, or was it kind of like competing at that point?
We were supposed to battle each other.
Okay, I've heard about that.
We were supposed to do a block, so them acting like they don't know, that's weird, because we were supposed to battle each other at one point, and for whatever reason, it didn't happen. So them acting like that, that's out of there for me. That's out of pocket.
Okay, so moving on. How does Trabo get on your radar? You coming back to the block? How did that all come about?
OSA wanted me to come back in the first place. A lot of people wanted me to come back, and again, like I said, my mind wants to do, but my heart wasn't in it. You know what I mean? And if I'm gonna come back, I want the biggest fish I can get. You know what I'm saying? I don't want.
So you didn't want a warm up battle. You didn't want a warm up battle.
I won, and I did what I did. I went out there and rocked with the. You know what I mean? And I'm gonna hang with them, you know what I'm saying? Like that's just what it's gonna be. But I definitely didn't want to be like, okay, so battle it, draw a miracle whip, and then battle it, his shoes, and then go on. Like, nah, hell no. Like, I was jumping in to jump in, and that's exactly what I did from a 3-year break. And the day that I actually wanted to do it, I called Oso, I linked up with Trabo, we spoke on the phone. I started writing as soon as he said yes. The minute he said yes, and I hadn't had or any want to write at all, you know, in the past. And now I was like, okay, now let's wake this demon back up. Let's wake this back up in me. And man, that first 2 weeks was hell. Cause I was like, bro, I'm not shaped up. The sword's so rusty, you know what I'm saying? That's how I felt at the time. But then once it started, you know what I mean, snowballing, I was like, okay, cool. And then that's when you hear like the dopest shit I wrote, you can tell, you know what I mean? I was already greased up, you know what I'm saying? Like the ball was rolling, if you will.
So when you did your research, did you see how different the block had changed? And now, was there even any feeling a type of way when it's like, you know, you're the logo, but now there's a new logo that's being pushed? I'm for sure that helped with the competitiveness of it all.
It's funny you say that. I didn't see that at the time as much. I knew that he was huge. I didn't know, but I didn't follow it enough to be like, oh, it's him. It's right. Him now.
He said you checked out.
Exactly. So, I mean, I'd seen some battles, right? I don't follow every fucking thing people do. I'm not going to sit in my room all day and catch up on all the black battles I missed. But I'll see them as they come out. And I watched probably a handful. And when he was like, let's rock, I was like, cool. So I watched his block battles. I ain't seen none of the shit he done out of town. I don't know none of that, you know what I mean? Because I see all the recommendations and everything. You type his name and it's going to pop up shit. I watched a handful of them. I was like, all right, that's what I'm facing. You know, and then just let it rock like that. You know what I'm saying? But it was definitely wanting to dive in and getting the fucking biggest name I could get. Who is it? Oh, it's Trabo. Okay, then let's rock.
Did you see some of yourself in Trabo?
Like what I said,
not necessarily as battles,
he a cool dude, he cool as hell, you know what I mean? And it was his block, that was for sure. I mean, I remember I said a couple things and I got no reaction, and I knew what they was about. I was like, shit, ain't my block no more. It ain't my block no more. That was a gut wrenching feeling then at the time. And not to say like, oh, it's supposed to be mine after 3 fucking years. Like, get the fuck out of here. Like,
you're realistic.
Right, so like, get the fuck out of here. So I was like, it's just hit. All you can do now is push your shit out. Just get it out. Like, just go through it. No stumbles, no fumbles. You know what I mean? Just rock. You know what I'm saying? And that was the first time I've ever been focused so fucking much at the time limit. I was having my homies fucking hit the record on me. And even through, like the pauses and shit, I gave myself like a 4-minute cushion because I know I was pausing and taking breaths and stuff. So I was like, that's roughly 3 minutes. That's gotta be, so at 4, I gotta stop. You know what I mean?
So you're writing for time.
I fucking fought myself on that goddamn, that fucking clock on my phone.
And this is the first time, like, so before were there time battles or it was just like, hey, get your stuff off?
In my life, battled with time, ever. It was a roadblock. So when, like, Oso texted me, he's like, what's King want to do as far as time? And I said unlimited. I said this shit 2.5 months before we ever fucking rocked. And that's what it was. It was unlimited. Okay, got it. He says it wasn't, but I swore my mom, I pulled a text message up. And everything's been unlimited. Like skits, they wouldn't really discuss neither. it was never really discussed. It was never a thing. Like, it was just get it out and don't fucking drag on forever. You know what I'm saying? Get your shit over with and go over with. But it was definitely the first time I fucking focused my whole soul on, like, okay, don't waste these people's fucking time. Time, you know what I'm saying? Like, right. Call that shit, it's done. And then, you know, he rocked for a long time. And I was like, man, fuck, I had so much shit I took out. But again, you know what I mean? You take it on the chin and you keep moving. You feel what I'm saying? Like,
nah,
it was what it was.
Yeah, because it's like, I think sometimes liberties can be taken in situations like that. Right. And it could have went either way. You know, because when I do go back and watch the ballot, it does seem like there's a discrepancy in time. But of course, with it being Trebo's block at that time,
he could do whatever the fuck he wanted to.
Exactly.
And I was what I once did whatever the fuck I wanted to. Yeah. And so, and again, like I said, you take on the chin, keep moving, dog. Mm-hmm. But the fact that I was up there, I bang with the best of them still, you know what I mean? That was cool for me.
You definitely didn't have a bad shot.
I won on that one, as far as that, like, in that sense, like, shit, you went out there, bro, you ain't been here for a minute, you know what I mean? Everybody in this fucking room, you went from everybody knowing you, tugging on your shirt, hey, bro, come here, let me talk to nobody really being like, people were still like, oh, shit, right, you was here, but it wasn't like that no more. It wasn't like celeb status in the room for Live from the Block.
When you left, I believe it was like, when you left, and then, I think, OG Percy was running that.
Shout out OG Percy.
Yeah, shout out. I fuck with OG Percy.
I seen his shit on 85 South the other day.
Yeah, OG Percy had that shit for a minute, and then he stopped. And I don't really know too much about Trey Will and shit, because once he left, I stopped really fucking with it. Mm-hmm. I just seen OG Percy, because...
We grew up in a sense. Again, I'm about Trey, you know what I'm saying? I'm just turned 30, you know what I'm saying? Like, so... I feel like I said, I don't feel like I'm 50 years old up here talking to this shit like
that. You're the OG, though.
I'm not, but like,
the original GOAT.
The battle I do want to see is Ryu and OG Percy. I wish you could make that happen.
You know what? Thank you for that. Let's get to my next question. I know you said the only person you would want to come back and battle would be Oso, but if Ryu had an op list, or who are some guys that, you know, got away, who would Ryu put on his op list?
My first reaction is going to say zero. Done, because this is not me no more. Mm. But there was a time me and G's were supposed to
Molly
rock.
G's, okay.
There was a time me and G's were supposed to rock, and it just never happened. It was one of them. It was, in my mind, it was supposed to be like Chad G's King. Like, I wanted, you know what I mean? Sweep them up is what I wanted to do. That's how I felt at the time. Yeah. It just didn't happen. Shit don't happen sometimes. If it wasn't going to be Trebo, it would have been Low.
Okay.
Because, and again, all that has to do with is status. That has to do with I ain't fucking around. I don't want nobody, you know what I'm saying, that's not the biggest shit right now. You know what I mean? That's just how I feel. Do I deserve that? Probably not. You know what I mean? Because I need to earn my keep again. I would have to get
balled. Oh, no. I would feel you definitely deserve it.
Yeah. I mean, if it would be like that, then it'd be like that. You know what I mean? But for my sense, like, nah, homeboy, you come in here and just start demanding shit? Like, no, and I don't want to. You know what I'm saying? But Oso knows me. I know him. You know what I mean? At any time I text Oso today, like, hey, I'm ready to rock, he'd be like, fucking, let's do it. But... You know what I mean?
You versus Red, would that make sense to you? Because I think for an OG,
hey, glad you said that, because this goes back to, Pac wanted to battle me for a long time.
Shout out Pac-Man.
Shout out Pac-Man, man. And you know why I didn't battle Pac-Man? So I fucking like the dude. I ain't got no hostility against him. What do you want me to make some shit up? Like, I don't know. For me, battling was always something that, I don't know. I wanted your spot. I don't like the way you move. I don't like the way you do this. Red the same way. I like the dude. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no. And now they see. They're like, nah. We're gonna call each other bitch. And then now this battle, hug it out and type shit. I don't know. It just
shout out to Red, because he's the same mind frame too. You're not gonna talk wild. Right. Then we get on stage and we cool afterwards.
Yeah, I'm solid with that shit, bro. But he, again, these are the froggy dudes. This is a different breed. This is a different breed. People like to say my class. Well, my class did. My class had fucking felons. My class had people that was really fucking doing shit, really fucking out here. What do you want me to do? Just sit in the room all goddamn day and just all I do is battle rap. All do it. Yeah, we weren't perfect. You feel what I'm saying? But nah, this, I like them dudes, and I would never any hostile. I don't know. We shook hands, talked too much, too cool with each other for me to be I'm gonna get him the fuck out of here.
I'd rather them niggas make a fucking track than battle each other.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That point. Do you do any rapping? Do you have music? Do you do music as well?
Look, man, just to keep my tongue sharp, I have a Band Lab. You can see it on Band Lab. It's an app, Ryu. I got hundreds of songs. Hundreds. Some of them with him.
So, you know, I just want, like I said, the pavement is about giving people their flowers, their kudos, their credit. there's no Live from the Block. There's really not a lot of DFW battle rap without Ryau. So you may not even look at it from this point, but how proud are you to just to see where what you really sprouted, whether it be Live from the Block, DFW, the other leagues, it has to start somewhere. We're all standing on the shoulders of other people. So how proud are you just to see how really not just the block, but the whole area has flourished at this point?
I'm proud of you. Yeah, I'm proud of you.
Hold on, hit that one more time so I can get you on camera one more time.
Yeah, I'm proud of him for sure.
That's straight up.
I seen from here, I seen what it progressed to, and then he actually fucking cooked every fucking body. So I seen it, like, that first impression, like, and then the next impression, second, third, fourth, like.
I appreciate that, for
you
real.
Know what I mean, like, I seen that shit, like, firsthand.
For real. I don't, at the time, you know, when you're doing it, you don't know what you're doing as far as what people are seeing around you and what you're creating and things that other people may stand on and foundations and stuff like that. So I really appreciate that. It means a lot to me because at the time, you don't know what you're doing and now sitting back reflecting on it.
And then you know what I'm saying? He wasn't spitting bullshit either, like.
At all.
Like, he did this shit, and then amongst everything else going on in his life, you know what I mean?
See, that's a different story.
Be able to fucking sit down and that's not even for this.
That's a different. It wasn't easy. We came, we saw, we conquered, we did our motherfucking thing, man. And the fact that I can say it, I definitely had bricks in my hands putting this house together.
Most definitely is
something that I can fucking, you know, I sleep well at night with that. You know what I mean? Like, and I wasn't even really trying to do it. I was just trying to prove to people I could rap, prove to people that I could perform, work, network without social media. I got people doing it for me. You know what I'm saying? Not like my agent, by the way. I need his number. Get after me later. That shit is amazing to me. And now you see where the block is today. And again, I don't watch every battle. I'm not in there all the time. I dip and dabble, you know what I mean? Go in there and just see the structure and everything that Osama the Great has done, the adversity, the fucking ambition, the drive to want to do it and keep this shit afloat, man. It's fucking tremendous to me. It's amazing. Now this motherfucker don't even host his own show. See, that's why I want to battle that man. They don't even host his own show.
Hey man, we're gonna get out on that one. Live from the Block, the Pvmt Season 3. We got the original block, G-O-A-T, Ryau. Get us out of here, man.
Yeah, man. Y'all keep doing y'all's thing. All you little fucking weirdos out there, get off of social media. Stop doing that bullshit. Write and stay real and stay humble.
Real.
I'm out.
Let's go. Let's go.